Don't let me drown.
Also guys, I'm on a walk and I don't know, I've been colouring this morning. I was about to film, but then the alarm went off, but I've been doing colouring today. I literally feel like I'm gonna collapse. I didn't realise how bad my leaving it got. And then, like, I'm really lightheaded. I can't eat without a rainbow. Right? Yeah. My life's not a problem. I'm also gonna sleep without letting cut my hair like that because it's too mad. I look out to the shower and then I some awkward wear. It's really dark, but I turn my light on. There we go. I've had my meds. I'm quite tired. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really tired. I don't even know if my day is vlogging, but now I'm popping to the video. I don't know what it goes. I don't know if it's bad for my heart, but I did more colouring. I'll show you what I did. I did some more colouring. I fell out of hair, but I need to press my hair. I did that one as well as the other one. The thing I'm scared about with this admission is that I'm just not gonna get support again and just I don't know whether I'm wasting my time or not. I'm like trying to get help. But at the same time I need it. So it's a case of will I get it? Probably not. I'm gonna actually challenge the diagnosis and I'm challenging the medication because something needs to change because I can't keep living like this. Also I'm finding it really hard to record at the moment because of how I'm gonna try and get out in a bit. Get my passport, go cash out with my account because I don't have my debit card on me and just get something. That's the issue of the hospital. I don't eat the food that I go for the vegan option. But this walk avenue, it's like readily available, so the last few days I haven't eaten anything and I might feel like dead, which is what I'm down. Fun fact. Where was I with this? I literally don't know. I'm sorry that I look like that, I've just had to break down. Yeah, because I have. Do you know what bothering me? All everyone asks about is YouTube. Not, oh, how is Lydia? How's your channel doing? And it just really gets to me. I've done some makeup today. I'm supposed to be seeing the doctor. About getting some let's go out. And I need endosaurs, re-prescribing. Because I tried to eat. Like, I had a meal. It was a vegan meal. I vegan in the hospital because the food is, well, hospital food. I have a vegan meal. But I have endosaurs on me, which is easier for me to deal with. Like, a full meal is a lot. Like, I don't think they quite realise how bad my issues with food really are. And they try to get me to eat in the main area. And, like, I broke down. It just wasn't pretty. Going on a school leave to Amsterdam.
I've eaten two meals and that is a lot for me, not gonna lie. It's a big way of saying no, and I am really anxious. I mean, right, it's a bit hard. Normally I just wouldn't eat, and I'd be trying, but all of that, making sure that I eat this giant, and I'm letting me get away with having dentures to a point where I haven't actually got dentures written on this giant. Like, I have to eat, and if I don't, I'm busy hitting the floor. And it's hard, because my eating disorder is something I struggled with for so long. If anyone's wondering what I'm doing, I'm colouring in at the moment. It's forward of a talk. Trying to recover from an eating disorder feels practically impossible. Because it's everywhere. It's in drinks, it's in food, and I haven't for a bit been okay with it, but I've been able to eat whatever really, and I was fine. Then I started binging, and then stopped eating. And then when I first came here, I tried to eat, and then the first thing I did was throw up. I didn't even mean to. Like, I don't really know what is hard or not. That's recovery, isn't it? Recovery isn't easy, and like, I can't eat around people. That's the biggest thing for me. I just can't. I don't know what it is. I just know that my body and my brain won't allow me to. So, I did have a good moment today. Like, one of the staff members here sat with me while I ate lunch in a female-only lounge at a moment no one goes, really. And it was okay. Like, I was alone, I was thinking about every calorie and reassuring, like, though, like, it doesn't matter, like, does it, like, it's less than a daily intake, does it really matter? But I was panicking because I didn't know what it was, because it was hospital food. Then this afternoon took me to Asda and witness what I'm like when I'm picking food. Like, when I was picking what I had to eat, I was reading the calories and he wanted to stop it. The deal was I'm not allowed to cry for 2 days. I wanted some shift. That was the deal. But honestly, like, it's great. It's helped me a lot, didn't it? Because I started having flashbacks earlier, and just needed an escape, and I was getting really wound up by it. I was pacing around my room, and I hid under a blanket, and it's hard. Kind of what today's been about for me. Food. Today's been about food. I finished doing green bits too, which makes me happy, because I'm trying to colour like a picture of the day, and let me tell you, I need to stop turning everything I do into like some big challenge, because colouring is like these books are supposed to be like calming, relaxing me. I need to finish the day, because I need to deal with myself. It's not fun. It's not fun. I did say no drinks, but I'd like to just, before I press record, I was going to try and throw up everything I'd eaten. And I literally stopped myself. I was like, why do I want to do this? So, for me, that's a big deal. Like, I genuinely said no to something that's controlled my life for a long time now. And that was a huge, huge, huge deal for me. Eating and food is something that has just impacted me for so long.